free TV.
Good morning, Eisenhower.
Live from Studio 317 ETV, I'm your host, Cameron, along with Ixchel.
Today is Tuesday, October 20th, Day A. Today in history, on October 20th, 1864, U.S. President Lincoln formally establishes Thanksgiving as a national holiday.
Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated.
And now for today's announcements with
Eric
and Matt.
Good morning, I'm Eric, along with
Matt.
What does today's weather look like?
Sunny today with a high near 70. Clear skies tonight with a low of 46. Wednesday will be sunny along with a few clouds, high of 73. Now here's Eric with today's announcements.
Thank you, Matt. If you're interested in joining the EMS girls basketball team, keep in mind that physical forms are due to the nurse by Monday, November 9th at 3 p.m. The girls beat Wycliffe Lake yesterday 2-0. Very tough game played by both teams. The Lady Generals really played a tough in the second half of the game. Lauren had a great goal with an assist from Grace D. Bella had a beast goal with another assist from Grace D. Grace D literally dribbled through Woodcliffe Lake's defense during the second half of the game. All the girls played tough and never gave up. Please come and support the Lady Generals today, home against Montville. The boys' soccer team won their seventh straight game with a score of 5-0 over Woodcliffe Lake. Scoring for the Generals were Liam with two goals, Pierce, Will, and Jacob as also scored a goal apiece. Assists came from Gavin, Jonathan, and corner from Pierce. Brennan played a great game in goal. A shout out to Jack, who had a great game on defense, and to Mitch, Tyler, Spencer, Greg, Orgus, and Alex, who also played a great game. The boys take Montville today. Good, go Generals. Attention, all 7th and 8th grade boys. Are you interested in trying out for the Eisenhower School basketball team? There will be a meeting this Thursday, October 22nd, in Mr. Hunt's room immediately after school. If you cannot make the meeting, please see either Mr. Hunt or Mr. Finale as soon as possible. To repeat, boys basketball meeting this Thursday, October 22nd, room 208, right after school. Hope to see you there. It's here. The winter play is finally here. Auditions for this year's winter play will be today, October 20th, and Thursday, October 22nd, at 3 p.m. in the multipurpose room. We are looking for actors, stage crew, art crew, and anyone else who would like to be part of the fun. The winter play is also open to all EMS students. Come one, come all. Please pick up the information packet in front of the office or Mr. Levy's room. Remember, the information packet must be completely filled out prior to your audition. A splendid time is guaranteed for all. Here's Matt with the rest of the day's announcements.
Thank you, Eric. The Debate Club will be hosting its first debate of the fall season this Wednesday, 10-21. Right after school in room 506, James in 7E and AJ in 8M will be debating Sarah in 6M and Julia in 7B on the topic of gun control. All members are expected to attend as judges, but spectators are always welcome to watch. See Mr. W for details. The Social Studies Department would like to thank all those who participated in yesterday's annual school-wide geography day and what became the longest final in championship rounds in recent memory. Jason in 8H outlasted Cooper in 7E to claim the title as Eisenhower Middle School Geography B champion. Congratulations to all who demonstrated their knowledge and skills in a truly epic contest. All children should be able to play. Mad for Kids is collecting gently used soccer equipment such as cleats, shin guards, and balls for children in Guatemala. Please bring your donations to room 404. Attention all 6th graders, you won't want to miss your first 6th canteen at EMS. Find out if you're ready for the ultimate game. It's big, it's bold, and it's extreme. The wrecking ball is coming to EMS for your canteen. Don't miss the chance to hurl the wrecking ball at your opponents and see who will be the last one standing. Be there this Friday at 7:30 p.m. Get ready to dance to your favorite tunes with DJ Philip, check out the latest games, and try your luck with a chance to win some cool prizes. Have your parent or guardian register you by visiting the PTO website. Spread the word. The 6th grade canteen is this Friday. You won't want to miss it. Doors open at 7:20 p.m. Is Eisenhower celebrating any birthdays today?
There are no birthdays today. What's for lunch today?
Today's lunch is Taco Tuesday. What's tomorrow's lunch?
Tomorrow's lunch is beef gyro with lettuce, tomatoes, and tzatziki sauce. What's in the headlines?
After 9 years, Canadian Prime Minister Stephen Harper and his Conservative Party's rule came to a sudden end. Justin Trudeau led the Liberal Party to a surprise victory.
And now for today's feature with Colin
and Ashlyn.
Thanks, Eric and Matt. When do you think about Barbies? Usually, don't you think about kinetic and potential energy?
Well, this year's 6th grade science classes are taking Barbie dolls to new heights. Let's go see how the 6th graders are using Barbies for science.
Hey Eisenhower, have you heard of the new 6th grade science project, replacing the paper airplane project?
It's Barbie bungee jumping!
Now let's go see what teachers and students think about Barbie bungee jumping.
What is the process of this experiment?
The process was that the kids had to figure out how many rubber bands it would take to have Barbie do a safe bungee jump from 200 centimeters. So they collected their data, they came up with their prediction, and then we did the jump.
Gabby, what do you learn from this project?
We're learning about kinetic and potential energy.
What's different about this than to the paper airplane project?
Well, the paper airplane project was the scientific method as well, but we didn't feel it had enough of the physical science that we needed to include.
So what do you think of the new project?
I really like it because, you know, I got to throw Barbie off of a staircase.
What did you learn about potential and kinetic energy?
Well, I learned that potential energy is stored energy and that kinetic energy is energy like when an object is moving.
So what do you think of the new Barbie bungee jumping project?
I like the project because I also like science and it's fun with the kinetic and energy.
Thank you.
As you can see, students seem to really like the new Barbie bungee jumping. Keep jumping, Eisenhower.
No, G.I. Joe.
This angers me. Tomorrow's feature is on Miss Caputo.
And now back to our hosts,
Cameron
and Michelle.
Thank you, Ashlyn and Colin.
And now for the joke of the day.
How does a bear test its bathwater?
I don't know how. With its bare feet.
Thanks for watching, Eisenhower. Have a turnt Tuesday.